In this video, we will look at the counter and encoder measurement using Dewesoft SuperCounter. Unlike traditional counters, which usually output an integer value and show it only at clock times, the Dewesoft SuperCounter runs at an internal 102.4 MHz clock and outputs completely accurate values at each sample time. Now let us take a look at a presentation of the Dewesoft SuperCounter.
The software waits until the next count occurs and then calculates back to the exact angle or exact position of the sensor.
We have a wide array of different USB and EtherCAT devices which support digital inputs for counters. The DV43, Sirius, Krypton one-times counter, and the newly added IoLite counter model. The Dewesoft counter model supports many different types of angle sensors with patented super counter, precise angle and frequency measurement. Event counting with basic, up-down, and gated event counting, and waveform timing. Waveform timing enables us to measure the period, pulse width, and the duty cycle of a given signal. This mode is used in applications such as measuring pulse width modulated signals. Two pulse edge separation is used to measure the time between two rising edges between two measured signals. This can measure, for example, time of flight and speed of objects. If your counter application requires the software to continuously measure the counter position, even if acquisition is stopped, then Dewesoft has you covered. Let's take an angle sensor in a steering wheel, for example. We see that if we start the measurement, the current measured angle never starts at 0 degrees, but at the position it actually is. Recently, we added support for asymmetrical and symmetrical multi-gap gear tooth sensors. Now let me paint you a picture on how gear tooth sensors with multi-gaps work. If you are as clumsy as I am, maybe this has also happened to you. You are casually carrying a gear tooth sensor to the measurement system and trip, causing the gear tooth to drop from your hand and it chips one or more teeth. Joke aside, the concept for the new sensor mode came from engine manufacturers who need asymmetric crank angle sensors on the crankshaft, as they allow them to know the exact position of the shaft before a full engine revolution is complete. With Dewesoft, you can use the broken sensor by simply defining the sensor in the sensor database. The sensor will work perfectly and your measurement won't be affected by your little accident. To add a gear tooth, we open the editor, select the type of sensor and set the gear tooth ratio. After these easy steps, we use the newly added sensor in our measurement. As you can see, the sensor starts measuring the signal immediately after reaching the second gap between the teeth. We see that the gear tooth not only works, but it works better than before because the counter starts working after hitting the second gap. Before, we needed to make a whole rotation to get the correct position of the sensor.